Hey everyone, welcome to Pastor versus Producer. I am Pastor John and I'm here with
Chris,
also known as
Cabby 96.
This is gonna be a dynamic show, but before we get into it, I have to ask everyone, please subscribe, like, and share this wonderful platform where we listen to music that's popular to you, because I'm out of touch. We listen to music that you know about, because I like old school. And then we talk about issues of faith, society, love, hate, everything. We bring it together. And that is the show, Pastor versus Producer. Am I right?
Sounds pretty accurate.
Chris, what are we going to listen to right now?
This was kind of a producer pick, but today we'll listen to the return of the mighty Queen Beyoncé, the song Break My Soul.
It's first
new
of single all,
for her new upcoming album.
Which why is Beyoncé the queen?
Because she.
I feel you have to earn these. Okay,
yeah.
I'm not saying
that. Yeah, like she didn't earn. This guy said, I feel like you have to earn. Yeah, I feel so too. I agree. I think you have to earn them as well.
And you feel Beyoncé has earned the. Like Michael Jackson is the king of pop.
Yeah. I don't know what genre Beyoncé would be the queen of, but.
She's just the queen.
I think she's just highly regarded to the status of queen.
Okay, I respect her. I'm not saying I don't. I'm just
she just touches so many genres, so I don't know.
And my next question is,
ran R&B with Destiny's Child for a bit.
Was she the most talented member of Destiny's
Child? That's not what I said. I said they ran R&B for a bit. She was a part of the group, right?
But if she wasn't the most talented member, then how can she be the queen? I'm not saying
she was the front woman, wasn't she?
I mean, Kelly Rowland.
Was she the front woman or was she not the front woman?
Look, Chris, I don't want to argue with you.
I love Kelly Rowland. I think Kelly Rowland is amazing.
Okay. I'm just putting things out there. But you know, you're throwing what titles like Queen and stuff like that. I mean, you gotta carry these things down. I don't want the BeyHive or what are they called? I don't want them mad at me, but I'm just saying we need to, you know, think about these things. Okay. We need to think about these things.
The artificial intelligence scrapers are gonna find out you say BeyHive and they're gonna find this video somehow.
Hey, we love the BeyHive. We love Beyonce, everybody. I don't even need to listen to it. Yeah. 10 out of 10. All right. Okay, so we're gonna listen to, you said it's called what?
Break my soul. Yeah,
man, this sounds like it might be some kind of deep song, so
yeah.
Okay, let's hear it, man.
I won't lie, that was my reaction when I first heard the song, because I did not think she was gonna go in this route. Especially, it was just very funny too, because Drake went the route that he went with his album. So when I heard this, I was just laughing. I was like, that's so funny. But not because I didn't like it, but just because it was just funny. I didn't see that coming.
What year are we in, man?
Exactly.
Because I feel like it's 1999, 2000. That's a beat I would have listened to in like high school or something. I'm not saying it sounds bad. I'm just saying it's a shock.
I think she interpolated that song that you're thinking of. I can't remember the name of it.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. You won't break my soul. 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 I'm telling everybody. 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 Now I just fell in love. Now I just quit my job. I'm gonna find no drive. Damn, they worked me so damn hard. This is a beef I have with Beyonce. Okay, like she comes up with these anthems that I cannot, single ladies, all of this, but it doesn't really seem to reflect her life. Yeah. Like, I just quit my job. When's the last time you had a job, Beyonce?
That's why people appreciate Drake, I guess. Remember our conversation about him?
I mean, that guy makes me feel a little bit inferior, to be honest. He's holding the money and spit in my face. Like, I just feel like this is okay. This is going to be an anthem. I have no doubt about that.
And I think, I mean, I feel like it's very obvious that it's intentionally for people, if that makes sense.
Yeah, okay.
Like, it's for people, so it's one of those songs where it's like, I'm making it for you guys.
Okay.
It's not necessarily that. Like, you know, she kind of just made it like, she tried to she presented or packaged it like it was about her, sort of, and then like, like just kind of made it, you know?
Would you feel more in the vibe if the lights were flashing on and off as this played and I had a glow stick and I was like...
It'd make me think about the club and I'm not a fan of clubs.
But this is a club anthem, yeah, for sure.
I mean, I like club music, but I don't know, just clubs are, I don't know, hit or miss. I think it depends on who I'm with too, though, sometimes. Cause
I'll tell you one thing, Chris. You won't break my soul. Let's play. Let's go. Work by night, then all past five. Okay, I like this song. I'm not gonna lie to you.
Now that I think about it, though, Beyonce always does like anthems for people. Yep. Like Who Run the World Girls, Single Ladies, Break My Soul, even the Freedom song.
It's true.
Like it's not off brand. Brown Skin Girl. That was a big one.
So is
it's not off brand at all.
Is Beyonce really, who rates with her? You know, in terms of female artists.
Depends who you ask. If you ask a Beyonce fan, they'll say nobody, but if I'm being, yeah,
like in, I guess, R&B pop,
Rihanna's pretty close, if not right there.
Maybe more.
Rihanna's a great catalog, like, of hits.
But not as much as Beyonce.
No, because she's been on it longer, right? True, so enough. It's going to be hard to beat that. But Rihanna's like right there. Yeah, the
closest. Janet Jackson?
I guess. I think because she's a bit before, they don't really necessarily pair them side to side like that.
Talk about
No, I'm talking about the greats of all time, and I'm going to put Janet Jackson number one.
They be comparing her to Michael Jackson, so I mean...
Whoa.
Yeah, they do. So
who does that?
Everybody.
Everybody like who?
Everybody who talks about her performance skills.
Look here, y'all. Yeah. Look here, okay? Look here. I'm not gonna make enemies.
If he asked Beyonce, she'd probably give it to Michael Jackson.
Who would? Everybody would give it to Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson was the greatest performer of all times.
Every artist that's compared to Michael Jackson, they automatically say, no, I'm not. Like Chris Brown.
Yeah. He said that recently.
Bro. Don't bring Chris Brown into this conversation. We're talking about high level artists here.
It's only now you're just
being, we're talking about,
now you're just being disrespectful.
No. We're talking about Mount Rushmore artists here, and nobody is mentioning Michael Jackson, Beyonce, and then Chris Brown.
They're mentioning Michael Jackson and Chris Brown because of his dance ability and his singing ability. Because, like, when he did that BET tribute to Michael Jackson, everybody was like,
okay, that was good. Yeah. I'm not going to lie. That was good.
That's where it really started. But no, wasn't necessarily saying, like, he's Michael Jackson. Like, his catalog is not like Michael Jackson.
Because that would be ridiculous.
100%. Yeah.
And imitation is the greatest form of flattery.
I mean, he said he wouldn't be him without Michael, so.
Okay, that's what I'm trying to get at. Because okay, let's go. I like this song, though. Let's go.
Ain't taking no flicks, but the whole click snapped. There's a whole lot of people in the house trying to smoke with the yak in your mouth. And we back outside. We said you outside, but you ain't that outside. Worldwide hoodie with the mask outside. In case you forgot how we act outside.
Is Beyonce a better rapper than Cardi B?
In terms of rap performance, because I know sometimes Jay-Z, I think Jay-Z actually wrote on this song as well. When I look at the credits. But what I like about Jay-Z, though, he, like, makes you kind of sound like yourself, though. Like, when he writes for Dre, he writes for Beyonce. It doesn't sound like Jay-Z, technically. But in terms of rap performance, because I'll speak on that, because I think Cardi B writes her raps. Yeah, Cardi B.
I respect.
Don't be disrespectful.
No. What's his name? Artisan Fontaine writes a rap.
That's you're talking about Meg Thee Stallion. Meg Thee Stallion. No, that's Meg Thee Stallion's boyfriend.
No, but Party used to write from Cardi B.
Yeah, like she has writers, but
you guys are going too deep. I don't know who these people are. I don't know. I asked you a simple question.
She's written a rap before. Like let's not act like she's never written a rap before.
Keep the producer to the back.
Yeah, let's not act like she's never written a rap before.
To me, this kind of had a Cardi B flow in a way. So
Cardi B is a really good rap performer, but she is. Beyonce be having her moments though.
She does.
And then she can like integrate the singing into it too. So and she can dance. Adds a different dimension. Yeah,
she can.
That's a good question though. I don't think it's an easy answer, which is why I think it's a good question. But
it's a little bit. I think it's a little bit obtuse. I shouldn't have asked this question because Cardi B is a rapper. Like
yeah.
To just be
but Beyonce like rap like she can like rap in terms of like performance. Like she. Okay. She can. Like,
she's no Lauryn Hill, though. Yeah, we know what's up. Greatest of all time, right?
I'm thinking about raps, but sure. Yeah, she'll probably.
Lauryn Hill.
She doesn't write like Lauryn Hill, so.
Nobody does.
Yeah, so.
Nobody does. Give it to her. We know how I feel about Lauryn Hill. Okay, let's go. You won't break my soul. Let's go. You know, there are these rumors about like the Illuminati and all this kind of stuff with Beyonce. I'm not gonna get into all that. I just think you reach a certain level in society, people start to make up things about you. New Salvation, all right. I'm gonna let that go. I'm not even gonna touch it.
Yeah,
but the thing I want to say is, I find it amazing. Beyonce can use like the simplest lyrics and still have a banger, right?
Yeah.
Like there's nothing crazy about this song, but it does speak to you.
I think a big part of that is like when you choose like what like melodies or top like how you say something. I guess is like super important. Mm. Because it's true, like the lyrics are not anything like super profound or you know, but it's the way she's you know, and the I guess the environment the beat's giving it. So it
maybe she is the queen, man. Maybe she is the queen. This is growing on me. Let's see. What makes it that we all know? Can't break my soul. Have the stress and I'll take less. I'll justify love. We go round in circles, searching for love. We go up and down, lost and found, searching for love. Who's she telling? Everybody. I just wanted to stop it there. I don't know. That was ridiculous. Let's finish this song and then we'll discuss it.
That was what the warning was at the beginning of the video. epilepsy warning or something.
I'm not gonna let my kids watch this lyric video though, because
that's a release the job.
I feel like there could be some subliminal messages like in the pattern of.
It's a lot of rest.
Oh, wow!
Release the job.
Okay, I'm gonna give Beyonce credit. That song is dope, man.
It's a really good song. It wasn't what I was looking forward to hearing from her though, when as a first single, but it's a really good song.
But I think that's why she is what she, because she always surprises you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, she just throws out things you wouldn't have expected. Chris, what do you rate this song?
7.8, I think.
7.8, huh?
It's a banger though.
Okay, I'm gonna rate this a bit different, because I'm gonna rate this in terms of what she was trying to accomplish, I think.
Which was, I should give it a higher rating.
Yeah, like to make an anthem. Like, yeah, she succeeded, man. Yeah.
Now she passed that flying colors.
I'm gonna give this song as an anthem 8.5, because I think she did it.
100%.
I think she did it.
You might hear this at the next protest or rally.
You know what? Yes. But why? Like, anyway, there's another whole conversation about pop artists and, you know, politics and all of these sorts of things. But she did it. She did it. So, BeyHive, don't be mad at us. I gave it an 8.5. Chris agreed. I think that she did it. I look forward to listening to more of her music. But yeah, I also,
I'm looking forward to the album. 100%.
Well, I'm looking forward to Kelly Rowland though. Where's she? Like, where's she?
Did she drop an album? I think she dropped something not too long ago.
You just destroyed Destiny's Child, and then all of a sudden the other members fall into oblivion. Like, what's going on here?
Nah, they're fine.
They're fine. Where are they? Where's Kelly Rowland?
Kelly Rowland's husband is working with I can't remember. Somebody big, though.
You can't even remember. See, like that.
They're good money, though. They're good. Kelly Rowland is still, like, she's still around, too.
But what about the other ones?
That I can't tell you. Exactly. I feel like they're all still friends. I see snippets on Twitter.
What is it? LaToya Luckett? Is that?
Yeah, that's one of them.
Yeah, where's she at?
And then, Michelle?
She's not Beyonce, I'll tell you that much.
Michelle's the other one.
Okay, where's she at?
I think most of them are friends.
You have to be friends with Beyonce. You can't decide not to be your friend.
Michael Jackson, the Jackson 5.
But they're brothers.
Yeah, where are they?
Anyway, thanks for listening to a great episode of Pastor versus Producer. You know, please, as we've said so many times, we appreciate everybody who watches this. Please subscribe, like, and share this wonderful program. We always give Chris the last word. Chris, what's the last word?
Do not release your job. Don't do it. She's a billionaire. Don't do it. Plan before releasing.
You won't break my unemployment check. Yeah,
do
all right.
Not release your job. Not yet, anyways.
All right. Not yet. I think that's sage advice. Thank you, everybody. Take care. God bless. We'll see you on the next broadcast.